I was in the office when I got a phone call from the school and said, my son is struggling to breathe. And then you hear, okay, there's no pulse, there's no heart, and then you're going mad. They also always called him my sterkie, because everywhere I went, he went with me. He would always say to his mom, Papa, may nie wegren nie. If I go to the shop or something, then he will put on his shoes and run to the car. So yeah, now we had a very close relationship.
We get quite a huge variety of calls, from accidents to medical trauma, everything. So quite busy this side. We cover quite far, depending on where what happens, but usually out to Pietersburg and further. With transfers, we will go even further. So it's roughly about 120 kilometer circle around Bloem that we cover. Lucas phoned us and said there's an emergency at a pre-primary school. I think it took us about a minute and a half to get to the school.
I remember one of the cupboards in the school I broke it down because I was, I can say, yeah, I wasn't myself. I can't explain that feeling that you have there, that your fear, sad, mad, everything is running through you.
Good team is interpersonal dynamics. They should communicate well. They shouldn't be afraid to ask when they need assistance. The other thing is perseverance. This team that's working in Bloemfontein, very hardworking guys, they really see a lot. I think we're in the area, we're like a pillar, if I have to say so.
We knew when we got to the hospital and they got the scans back and they told us, listen, there's a lot of damage on the brain and stuff. And we knew it's going to be difficult. It's not going to be the same. Everything's going to have to change. Because the doctor also told us, like, if something like this happens in a family, the parents usually divorce and blame each other or something like that. But we decided there that we know it's going to be tough, but we're going to get pulled through it together. And but now it's a year later and yeah, we're still going strong.
This team that I've got here resus an average at least once or twice a day. Although it's not children as such, many of resuses are adults, so they're keeping training. They are motivated, they are here to save lives. And the other thing, the big secret I think in this case was that the teacher initiated early CPR. And early CPR saves lives.
We were quite fortunate that we were available and quite close to the school, as luck would have it. Yeah, usually the prognosis isn't good, but I think with a lot of prayer and a lot of grace from above, he seems to be doing quite well.
The doctors told us that basically, there's no chance for him to survive that. He won't be able to come out of the hospital, all his organs will give in. And a year later, he's laughing. You can speak to him and he will do something you ask him to do. After they saw him again, they said, listen, this kid is going forward and forward and forward.
With Jandre, every month it's something new. He's developing something new. When he was in hospital, he didn't have any movement. He couldn't move his arms, his legs, nothing. So now he's starting to roll over from the side to his back. He can stand on his feet. So my husband said that we will get through this. We have to get through this. So no matter what, we will stay together. We know it's a long road ahead, but we will make it in the end.
When Jandre was in ICU, he was there for 3 months. Every second day, there will be someone from ER there visiting him in ICU, asking us how he's doing. But just that, that I didn't give up, and that it wasn't even their child, and that they didn't give up on my child.